So who's buying all these condos? Who's buying all the Toronto condos? Prices are going up nonstop. It seems that there's just endless thirst for condos. People are gobbling up these condos. What's going on? Yossi Kaplan here, Toronto Real Estate Agent, Mortgage Broker Research Realty in Search Mortgage. And today we're going to talk about who's buying all these condos. All right, urbanrealtytoronto.com. When you get this, see this pop-up investor insider, put your name, your email, your mobile if you want the updates. Twitter.com/Yossi Kaplan for more updates. What I got here, the condo calculator. That's a tool I designed that will allow you to download this spreadsheet and you can calculate the carrying costs on these condos. Now, carrying costs on these condos in the north of $1,000 a foot has been yielding at the 20-80 rule, means 20% deposit, 80% mortgage. It's very, very hard to break even on them anymore, if at all. And of course, at 1,300 foot or 1,500 foot, you got to put 30 and 40% down to break even. So who's buying all these condos if these condos don't break even? Okay, so let's take a look, friends. The first thing I want to start with is I'm going to go to condos.ca. They got this little index here, and it says 830 a foot. This is for the city of Toronto, whatever condos.ca considers it. And it shows you 14.38% year-over-year change in values. And you can see the graph here. And you can see that we're looking at 818 here, 830 here. So obviously there's this price push up. And you can see how, generally speaking, this price is going up and up and up. That's 2016, and here's 2020. So in 4 years span, it just keeps going up. It may go down a bit in the winter, you know. It's a little cyclical, but overall, even the cyclical, even when it goes down, it's still up to the year before. Even it goes down here, it's up the year before, and it goes down up here, it's more than the year down, but it's still more than the year before. So who's buying all these condos? All right. Recently, I viewed what can you get for $1 million? Price up 20%. Did you pay too much? What can you get for $600,000? It just goes on and on and on. If you look for some video information about Toronto condos and investing in real estate, visit my channel. And thank you everyone very much for your support. It means a lot to me. TorontoCondosForSale.com will give you a list of all the pre-construction condos available. Just go to TorontoCondosForSale.com and then hit that button that comes in the top right here. And you'll see it right here. Projects in Toronto, and there you go. Now the question is, who's buying all these condos? I mean, why would you buy a condo if it costs too much? What sense does it make? Well, you know, people are not stupid. Obviously, when a lot of people are doing something, you can call it tulip, but you can also say they know something I don't. So I'm trying to understand what is the logic of the investors. And I'm an investor myself, and the logic is this. If I believe that the market tomorrow is going to be more than the market today, then I'd rather invest today and reap the benefits of what I sow today tomorrow. Here are the numbers. Now, this is the historic site from Treb Market Watch. They have an updated 2019 chart here. But you can see in the numbers here, 2017 was the highest year of record at 822. That's the average price of a Toronto home is 822,000. Now that takes the 416, the 905, the condos, the townhomes, the semis, the detail, everything, all the residential properties together. And we had a bit of a drop in 2018, average drop. Downtown didn't really drop, average drop, 787. And look at this, we are now at 837, 788 for December 2019. So the prices are pushing up all the time. And you can see here, all the prices, all the averages here. You know, the condos are stable, about 660. The townhome at about 717. The semis are about $1 million, that's 416. And detached about a 1.3 million. Look at these are the sales. So the price went up by 19, but almost 20% for the detached and 10% for the condos. And the number of sales went up by a lot. So people are looking, 38% more bought the houses. And that's why you see all the bidding wars. And 8.6% for the semis and 14.2% for the townhouses and condos. There's more of them, of course. So it's more regulated because there's so much product right now. And there will be more and more all the time. 5.1% still increasing number of sales. And 905 is just as busy. Just as busy, okay? You can download this for free, Market Watch. Go to Toronto Real Estate Board and download the Market Watch. And then you can drill down to all these numbers. That's not the point. The point is that there are people who are buying all these condos, and I'm going to tell you who they are right now. So it goes like this. The first, of course, are the investors. And those investors, they buy the units to do two things with them. Number one is to flip them, or they just want to keep them and rent it to someone else. Now, just a month or two ago, I showed you Keeley and price of the Keeley, and two bedroom for about $600,000. These are about, $1,000 a foot, give or take a little more, a little less, but they average around $1,000 a foot by York University. There's lots of product there in that corner, and this is a great project, and it's part of a larger development, and there's still a couple units available and more coming via assignments. And the Keeley itself is unique because it sits right across from that little artificial lake, so, and it's kind of halfway to York, and that's the big park here. So to me, it's really nice. I mean, it's pretty nice to sit here and look at the water. That's pretty cool. I don't know, if you have one of these units, you may do really well. And we went deep in the calculations and we actually figured out that the one bedroom unit, they're cheapest. So if you need something, you just want to invest something, you can buy them. But once you get into the two and three bedroom, you can actually start looking at better ROIs because these units are divided between two and three roommates and they each pay a bit more in rent each. And then you can start getting more value out of these units, more ROI, okay? And that you'll do with use the condo calculator to figure it out. I'm not gonna do it now. There's lots of videos explaining. So the first type of people that buy the condos and they wanna flip them or they wanna make them into a rental. That's true for Untitled, that's true for 411, who's shortly gonna be released. That's true for the Sky Tower, that's true for 31, that's true for all these condos, okay? The Forest Hill, nearly sold out or sold out now at about $1,300 a foot. Okay, the same. For example, we have a lot of very small units. So it's more of a rental building, but instead of one company building the building, there's a whole bunch of individual investors buying each a unit or two, or some of them buy more than one, or Galleria that averaged on the opening day $963 a foot, and now it's about $1,000 a foot, still quite reasonable. 123 Portland is in a $1,300 a foot. It's a small boutique building by Minto, right on Portland, just between King and Queen. To me, it's a really nice building. I like, I like boutique buildings. I like unique value. I like stuff that lasts a long time. But also, if you go up to up Yonge Street, Richmond Hill, Thornhill, you can get a lot of good value there. Because there's a lot of people coming in Toronto, and that's the thing. Toronto is adding a lot of people, a lot of population. Nordic just came so fast, and there's a lot of product around Nordic on the Tippett Road there. So that's 401 in Allen area. Lots of stuff going on there. Okay, and it's endless. Now you can find stuff maybe at Monza, which is St. Clair West, Galleria, which is, like a few years ago, I go, do you want to live at Dufferin and Dupont? What are you kidding me? Like, this is a crazy area. Well, now it's the most sought after area. So things change really, really quickly, okay? Change really, really quickly. And if somebody didn't want to live at Yonge and Eglinton before, Yonge and Eligible, as we call it, now it's all the rage. And once you get priced out of Yonge and Eglinton, you're going to go to the next place. You're going to go around here to Wilson. And then when that runs out, you're going to go to the next place and the next place and the next place and the next place. So the city is growing outwards, okay? The city is growing outwards. That means that if I invested in King West today and King West is too expensive, I'm going to move maybe slightly west of there, maybe Queen West, and that gets more expensive. I'm going to move a little bit west of there. Maybe that's west of Dufferin, and that gets expensive. Maybe I go 57 Brock. When that's expensive, then I'm going to start looking at St. Clair West. When that's expensive, I want to go to Galleria. On and on and on. So now you have two options, okay? The investors who are buying, they have two options. They're buying to live, or they're buying, and that's kind of the second half of who's buying all these condos. So they're gonna buy to live, or maybe they buy for their kids. They say, I'm gonna buy this condo. Maybe my kids are about to finish university, or they're gonna go to university in York. I might as well just buy that condo. And that's what a lot of people do around the U of T. Or they can say, my kid's going to be a computer engineer. I'm going to buy them a condo. It's expensive condo at The Well by Tridel. But Shopify is going to have a huge R&D center there. They're probably going to have 1,000 employees. Just Shopify. You're looking just Shopify, 1,000 employees. And all I showed you in a previous video, they make $120,000 to $180,000 for the software engineers. They're still in their 20s and 30s. And they need a place to live. Everyone needs a bed. So I'm going to get this one here, and maybe the parent will put the deposit and the kid will carry it. You'll see a lot of that. There's something for everyone, okay? So Tridel is really good. Galleria, when it came out, people looked at me like, you're crazy, but then 1,000 people showed up to the opening, and the worksheets, it's like 10 worksheets per unit available. Now what happened, and it sells out. a lot of gallery information, but there's more towers. Just the first two sold so far. There's six more to go. And then if you priced out there, you can go to Crosstown by Aspen Ridge and go on DVP 401. And that's also a master plan community. And recently, a couple of days ago, actually, another huge master plan community is coming at Square One Mississauga. So people snubbed Square One. You may not snub it anymore because it's all fair and square, because there's a lot of really great places in Toronto to live. There's really no bad place. I mean, we don't have bad areas here. We're very lucky. Everything's clean. It's safe. Toronto's an amazing city. Everyone's coming to the city. It's very good. It's very, very good. Okay, so that's who's buying the condos. Let me show you a couple more things, okay? Let's zoom down here. There's a lot of articles. This is urbanrealtytoronto.com. It's my main site. I've been putting a lot of articles here. People are going all the way to Niagara. Niagara sold out, but that's very, very sought after because those are Airbnb condos. So they legalize them in the condo docs and with the city of Niagara to make sure that they can do short-term leasing. It's all in the open. It's all transparent. Everyone understands these are Airbnb condos. That's what they're for. And Niagara welcomes it because bringing more tourists to Niagara is what Niagara needs. You know, it has to compete, of course, with the Niagara USA for the same tourists. So we like them to come to Canada, of course, and the Americans like to come to the States. We have to offer more and more options for the tourists to come to Niagara. It's one of the seven wonders of the world and one of the most sought after tourist attractions. So that's also a fair investment. The master plan community, as I said, Galleria, Tridale, Crosstown are very good. The other thing is, you can always invest in an assignment. Once an assignment, somebody bought the condo from the developer and then they're flipping it to you. They're reassigning this contract to you, and you can see how to buy the assignment, how to sell the assignment, what you need to do. Now, if you want to buy the assignment, look at how to sell it. If you sell the assignment, look how to buy it, because that's going to give you an idea of what the other person does. It's going to show you how to search for assignments. It's going to give you an idea of what people are asking for. And also, assignment is really good because if you're selling the assignment, you can put some money in your pocket. But if you want to invest in a certain area and you weren't able to do before for whatever reason, you can do it now. And that's what assignment gives you, okay? Or you can wait till it's on the open market. But that's what I mean. So you're going to buy the condo if you want to live there. You want to buy the condo if you want your kids to live there, which is really like part of retirement, part of passing the torch to the younger generation. You know, so if you have kids, a lot of my clients are investing with the idea that their kids are going to use these units, they're going to live there, or it's going to be income for their kids or income for retirement. A lot of people buying to flip. So a lot of people that are buying the more expensive condos, let me go back here. A lot of people that buy the more expensive condos, they buy to invest in the long term. Somebody came to me and said, you know, I found a pre-construction in Yorkville and it was $1,500 a foot, and I know they're going to raise the price to $1,800. So I took a couple of units because to me it makes sense that $300, that's 20% markup already built into my price. I might as well invest it. Well, why would you invest in an entitled condo besides all the hula that they got some rap star to represent it? It's because it's a really nice project and it's a really well-designed community, and Yonge and Eglinton is the place to be, and you don't need to be on the subway anymore. You don't need to come to downtown anymore. You know, I'm not a big proponent of going on the subway. Go on BlogTO and see what's going on in the subway. It's unbelievable. It's just, you know, you can't carry the people anymore, so we're back to localizing where we live, and that means that I want to live and work in the same area, so I don't have to go on a subway. I don't have to commute. I can just walk over. And a lot of the, you know, probably like half of the professions in 10 years are going to work from home. You're going to process some information on your laptop at home, talking on the phone, on a chat line, on the phone, and doing your computer stuff, and that's what you're going to do. So you got 750 units coming in untitled. I could use a better name than untitled. It's I don't know. Like, it's a nice building. Why not give it a nice name? But it's all good, and it's a viable investment. So these are the people who are buying the condos. Why are you buying a condo? Chances are you're going to buy to flip, you're going to buy to invest for the long term, or you're going to buy it as a family investment. These are the main things that you see now, okay? If you have some extra money and you want to put it somewhere and you do not trust the banks, you do not trust the financial system, a lot of people, especially come from Asia, you know, they not necessarily want to trust the governments. We can see what's going on these days. So they want to invest. Now, if you you can always invest in resale, because resale tend to be cheaper these days than the pre-construction. But you need to close on it. You need to move in. In the new construction, the pre-construction, of course, you just put your 15% down and then you just wait. So you have options. You have a lot of options. If you want to know what your options are, ask me. Some people like to buy the two-bedroom, Young & Lawrence, like this one here, 1717 Avenue Road. Some people are really stuck on the downtown, and that's totally fine. There's a lot of product there, so you got to be more careful. And some people are moving out of the city completely all the way to Hamilton to invest. Nonetheless, you can say that real estate is a tool for investment, is a tool to help you grow your personal portfolio larger all the time. 488 University, barely can find any units. I don't have any more units left here, but I hopefully I will very soon. That's a phenomenal investment, in my opinion. Can be one of the best things you've ever done, okay? So that is about who is buying all these investments. Leave in the comments if you want and share with me, why do you think people are buying these condos? Why did you buy your condo? What made you invest in real estate? Whether it was a condo, a bungalow, a ditch house, semi? Curious, like to know. Thank you very much. Yossi here, and that's it for today. Take care.